Hi there, welcome to this special YouTube video, and I like this title. It's titled How to Discourage or Demoralize Your Man, or you can call it How Not to Discourage or Demoralize Your Man. But basically, there are some things men have been complaining about forever that women do that totally discourage them or demoralize them. Some of them are things I've observed, some are things I've heard men complain about. So I'll give you seven quickly, and I hope this blesses you. So number one. All right, things that women do that demoralize or discourage men is not appreciating his efforts. Oh my God, this one is so powerful. Not appreciating his efforts. Now, women need to understand the way the woman's mind is wired. She doesn't really separate certain things. Okay, so let me explain. A man's brain is like rice. So everything is different. So if we're talking about this aspect is separate from this aspect, you know, rice is separate. A woman's mind is like spaghetti. Everything is mixed up and jumbled up. They are all one and the same. So this means that if a man is making efforts to make a woman happy, as long as he has done something else wrong, she finds it difficult to separate these efforts in this area with the area he's not doing well. So she generally is tempted to give him a bad vibe altogether. Not because he didn't try today, but because of the one that happened last week, all right? So, and again, another thing about women's mind is that women have the gift of details. You know, they're generally more detailed. That's how they are wired. They were created, their minds are, their brains are totally different from that of a man. So their brain is wired to notice details. And the problem with having a brain or a mind that is good with details is that if you're not careful, you can become petty. So that's why if you see guys living together, guys can cope. So if there's a dirty plate beside the guy's bed, as long as the bed is okay, the guy will sleep comfortably even though there's a dirty plate there. But the woman will struggle with that because of their sense of details, they will notice that thing that is bad. All right? And this can go even a smaller thing. So they generally can become petty. This is why men say women are petty. It's not their fault. Just how their brains are wired, they can't separate all those things. If the bed is not well laid, it can affect how something else will happen. If there's a dirty plate somewhere, it will affect how they will feel. It's the way they are wired. Even women don't, some women don't even know this. It's the way they are wired. They are given to details. This means they can become petty if they don't manage it well. So what am I trying to say? I'm trying to say, hey, learn to appreciate the efforts. Now, never mark your guy's efforts by 100% score. If he's putting 5% effort, if that's what he's putting in, and 95 is not yet done, appreciate the 5%. Because the way men work is that once you appreciate the 5%, he will get very high and intoxicated with the appreciation. He will tend to do more. He will want to please you like that in the remaining 95%. But what women usually do is that when a man is putting in 5% effort and 95 is undone, a woman will focus on that 95 that is not done and be angry. All right? Even when the man is doing 95% effort and 5% not done, a woman's mind is wired to leave the 95 that is going well and focus on that 5% that is not doing well. So as a woman, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, in spite of the temptation to complain about this 5% that is undone, praise him about the one that is done. That's the key. You see, men run away from areas they feel they are not doing well. That's what men do. If a man feels pleasing you is not going well, that he's not doing well in terms of impressing you, his solution to the matter is running away. His solution to the matter is not trying at all. Because men, as they have ego, their ego is fragile. So they hate being where they feel they are not doing well. This is why there are many places you don't find men so active, because they feel, I'm not going to do well there. They like to go to a place where there's no judgment, where there's nobody's judging their performance. So that's why men like to hang out in places like bars and things like that, because in a bar, you know, everybody's there to drink. Nobody's judging you. No matter what you say, in a bar, nobody's angry. you know, because they're all drunk. You know, so learn to appreciate the little efforts. It's going to be a struggle for many women because they're used to complaining about what's not working. Instead, focus on what's working. So what do I mean? Your husband is not romantic, but he's hardworking. When he comes home, praise him that, hey, I like the way you're hardworking. That even though you're not as romantic as I would like, but hey, to be honest, you are a great provider in the home, or you are great with the kids, or, you know, I like the way you drop me off at work. Find something to thank him for and thank him, praise him. He will get so intoxicated with the praise. And he will start stepping up by himself on the other areas that you need him to step up, all right? So drop those other areas as hints, but focus your praise, you know, on the areas he's doing well. So not appreciating efforts makes men run away. It demoralizes them, they run away, because men hate to be in atmospheres that they feel they are not doing well. You need to understand, men are wired for competition. So for a man, everything is competition. If he's not doing well here, instead of him to stay here and lose, he'll rather go and focus on where he's winning. That's why many men try to go to work instead of, because family life, they just feel they don't have a grasp of it. They're not as emotionally developed or emotionally savvy as women. So they just focus on areas they are good at, football, sports, work, and run away from emotional life, all right? So appreciate his efforts. You will encourage him and not demoralize him. Number two. Number two, not understanding timing. This one is also important. Women, you need to understand this. There's something about timing, all right? Your point can be right, but there's also a right time to bring up the point. Sometimes, because women are very emotional, they can get very feisty, very hot, very, you know, and they just want to, you know, say it at the time that is paining them. They want to just give it to the man at that time. Listen, you must understand that there's timing is important, especially when you're dealing with the opposite sex. Timing is important. Your point can be right, but are you saying it at the right time? Is this the right time to bring up this issue? All right, when the man is frustrated or demoralized or feeling bad that he's not doing it well at work or whatever, that might not be the right time to add more failures, to tell him, remind him more of his failures in other aspects. That might not be the right time. That might be time to even encourage him and lift up his spirit, as opposed to adding more complaints that, oh, you're not doing this, you're not doing this. All right, so try to manage your timing to know, is this the right time to bring this up? Is this a good time, you know, to bring this up? And now, also talking about timing, you need to even know, especially for those that are not yet in a relationship, that are not yet married, rather, or even not yet in a relationship, you need to understand timing. When a man is showing interest in you, understand timing. Men can also get demoralized or demotivated when you give in too quickly, all right? Let them express. Men are hunters, they want to chase. You know, the worst thing you can do is to, like, imagine an antelope leaving the bush, coming to the hunter's house, knocking. Hunter opens the door, he goes to the kitchen, enters the hunter spot. There's no motivation for that hunter. You know, that hunter will find it hard to even eat that antelope. All right, so let him express, don't be quick to fast track the process, you know, and just say, oh, he has never asked you out and you have said yes. You know, you don't even, he's still just chatting with you regularly, then you have gone to his house to spend the night. You know, those kind of things, timing, you are demotivating him when you give in too quickly to things that should only happen when there's a committed relationship, things that should only happen when there's even marriage, but you are giving it too quickly. You have already started cooking, sweeping his house, and having sex with him. You are demotivating him, all right? I as a counselor, I see this all the time. In 3 months, a woman has slept the guy, done abortion, and started even washing and cleaning his house, and she's thinking he will continue to chase. He's done. No motivation. Nobody pays for the cow when the milk is free. You need to understand that. Let him express, let him chase, let him show commitment. Don't just jump the hoops, don't jump the hurdles for him too quickly. Let him come, all right? You and the guy are chatting and he's inviting you. Let him come see you, all right? Understand timing. Don't just enter the bus, enter the plane and travel to go and see him. Small things like that discourage him from chasing you. You see, the way men's mind work, men are project driven. The moment the project is over, he has lost motivation. Even him can't explain it sometimes. All right, that's why in a wedding, men see the wedding as the end of something. Women see the wedding as the beginning of something. So women see the wedding as the beginning of the marriage. Oh, we're going to start doing many things, many changes I've had in my mind. Men see the wedding as the end. I'm complete. I've married you. So can I move on to something else now? So you need to understand that. Don't demotivate him by giving in too quickly to certain things. Let him show commitment. Let him chase you. Let him go through the hurdles for himself. Don't jump over the hurdles to him. All right, very important. Number three. Not understanding submission. All right, not understanding submission. All right, so you need to understand that men are generally wired to lead. All right, I know people will argue with these things, but if you look at scriptural precedents, look at character, look at statistics, look at behavior, if you study human behavior, you will notice that men are not so wired to be directed. They are more wired to give directions. That's just how they behave. Those people that have raised kids, you will discover that you start losing control over your sons first. You'll find out that at a certain age, boys just hate being told what to do. You know, women are generally more submissive, more adaptive. You know, if you check scripture, the Bible said when God was going to create a woman, he said, I'll make him a helper that is suitable and adaptable. Women have incredible ability to adapt. That's just how they are. They generally adapt easily. Women are great at sitting down to listen. If you see in churches, there are more women than men. Women are good with sitting down to listen. Men hate to sit down to listen. Men hate to be told what to do. Counseling, same thing. More women want to come for counseling. Men don't like to come for counseling. And even the few men that will come for counseling, you'll find out they are resisting change. They hate the fact that that man wants to tell them what, or that man or woman wants to tell them what to do in their lives, what to do in their mind. So that's why men hate those kind of things. Men always tell you, we don't need counseling. You know, but a woman doesn't mind listening. A woman doesn't mind somebody telling her what to do, but men hate it. All right, so generally, I'm just saying all this to lay this foundation that look, if you're a woman and you want to marry a man, or you want to date a man, or you want to flow with a man, one of the things you need to learn is that, am I able to submit to this man? Do I trust this man? When the Bible says women should submit, it doesn't mean women should be slaves. However, it means that you must be willing to walk with this guy. You must be willing to allow him to lead. All right, you must be willing to, do you trust his decision making? You know, God didn't say you should submit to all the men worldwide. What he's saying is that, look, make sure you're choosing a man that you are ready to walk with. All right, so understand submission. You can't always argue. Women always try to fight for the steering with the man. And by steering, I don't mean just literal one, okay? They want to fight for control all the time. You know, men want to, you know, take the lead. They want to chart the course sometimes. Be willing to say, hey, do I trust this man's wisdom? Do I trust his decision making? Can I follow him? Can I be adaptable to him? All right, it's very important. Tussling for control with a man is one of the ways you frustrate and discourage a man. He will just leave everything for you and go and start a new life or a new family and things like that, because they would rather do that than struggle with control. All right, next point. Not believing in or supporting his dreams. This is another thing that frustrates men a lot. All right, many men are married to women that don't even believe in them. All right, one of a man's greatest needs is to be supported and be believed in. All right, so if you are going to marry or date a man, be sure that you believe in his dreams. All right, believe in his dreams and support his dreams. All right, men always fall in love with the person that believes in them and supports them. Very important. All right, very, very important. So if you are with someone, or you want to be with someone, or you are married to a man, constantly ask him what his dreams are and believe in it and support it and pray, you know, about it. It's one of the ways you motivate and encourage a man, by believing in or supporting his dreams. Very important. There are some women that don't even know what their husbands or men's dreams are. They don't even know what it is. You're talking hours and hours with a guy and you've never discussed, you know, his dreams. You know, men are very particular about their work, about what they do. That's how to get their soft side, about what they do. So anybody that believes and supports what they do, we generally get their attention and get their hearts. All right, very, very, very important. Next point, not showing respect, especially publicly. Men find submission and respect very sexy. Let me say it that way, very sexy. Most men think it's just my shape that is sexy. No, respect. Men find respect, you know, very attractive. That's what I'm trying to say. Men find respect very, very attractive. It's just the way the man is wired. So if you are a woman, resist the temptation to talk down at that man. Resist the temptation to cut him to size. Many women think it's their job to cut him to size. Many women think, oh, men have ego. My job is to remove the ego. You can't remove the ego. Your job is to work with that ego and know how to influence him, all right, by respect. Men love respect. I always share the story of that woman I call the unforgettable woman in the Bible. Her name is Abigail. All right, David was married to one woman that didn't believe in his dreams, that one woman that didn't believe in him. Her name was Michal. She was King Saul's daughter. You know, David didn't actually toast that girl. David didn't choose that girl. They gave, you know, David that girl as a gift. You know, this is one of the reasons why I'm not a big fan of hookups or introductions or dating sites. When people don't meet naturally and chase each other naturally, it's like an artificial joining. there's usually cracks because their values are not the same. These are people that ordinarily wouldn't have made it to the dating stage if they met naturally. But we have kind of fast-tracked them to dating stage because we introduced them, you know. So that's what happened to David. So they gave him a lady called Michal, King Saul's daughter. It was part of the prizes he won for killing Goliath, you know. So, but this girl didn't respect David. This girl didn't believe in David's dream. You know, when David was bringing the ark back to Jerusalem also, and he was dancing, you know, the lady was saying, why are you disgracing yourself? Dancing like one of the common people. You don't know you're a king, you're disgracing yourself. You know, she didn't support David. But David met a woman called Abigail. The Bible said, Abigail met David and knelt down to talk to him, called him Lord about 10 times in one conversation. You know, shared with David his dreams. That means she already knew David's dreams. She knew that David was going to be king one day. And she told David that, you know, I don't want you to come and kill my husband because you will dirty your hand, because we know one day you're going to be king. So she touched all the bases that encouraged men, you know, respected him, talked to him about his future, talked to him about his dream. I mean, David was so taken by this woman. He had never seen a woman like that. The moment her, I mean, it was so incredible that, you know, as David left that place, he never forgot her. That's what I call the unforgettable woman. There are men or women you meet that you never forget, you know, and she was that kind of woman because she understood what it meant to be a woman. And as David left there, David took her Instagram handles and he kept checking her updates, kept checking her status, kept liking her posts, kept commenting, you know, because the moment she posted obituary of her husband, David ran there to marry her, you know, at that old age. David still married her because she was an unforgettable woman, and it's because she was respectful, not just in private, but even public. So if you're a woman, hey, show respect. Even if you don't want to marry this man, even if this guy you are with, you're not even sure you're going to marry him, but respect has a way. It just makes you look more beautiful than you are. It's just amazing. It gives a smell, a scent of a beautiful fragrance when a woman is respectful. I know one of the things men complain about is a woman being saucy. There are many women, the kind of women I see these days, they are so saucy, their mouths are so sharp. Now, they respect pastors, or they respect us when they see us, but when they are with, you know, people that are their contemporaries, people that they are mates or their friends, the kind of attitude I even see, I'm shocked. You must learn to be respectful, not just to your parents, not just to elders, but even every human being. Learn to be respectful. Very, very important, okay? Learn to show respect, both privately and publicly, all right? The next one where you can discourage a man is not being emotionally responsible. This one frustrates men a lot because women are generally a bit more emotional, way, way more emotional than men. And this frustrates men because sometimes a woman causes drama and she doesn't want to be responsible for it. You know, sometimes a woman allows her own emotions to push her into relationships, push her into having premarital sex, push her into giving more than she ought to give a guy. And then when things go sour, she now makes it look like, oh, you know, you have killed me, you hurt me. But you see, you need to be responsible for your own actions. You need to be responsible for what you did by yourself, all right? Nobody forced you. So take responsibility. The worst thing that men complain about, a woman will cause drama, argument will start, she will just start crying. When she starts crying, game over. She has won. So be more emotionally responsible, all right? I know that you are way more emotional than men are, but also you need to take some control and some responsibility of how you act and feel. You know, many times when a man is arguing with a woman, he doesn't even know what the argument is about. By the time we are done, he doesn't even know what the argument, where did we start, where did we end? Because women just start roping other things, you know, into the argument. That's how you always shout at me. You never listen to me. And I thought this was about this issue, but she will move it to other issues. Hey, be a bit more emotionally responsible, all right? You frustrate and demoralize a man, all right, when you give him stress. One of a man's major needs is peace, all right? In fact, the scripture says it this way, that when a man is married to a contentious woman, he will go and live on top of the roof, or he'll go and live in the wilderness. That's how much a man likes peace. He will run away just to get peace. Peace is a major need for men, all right? So try and be less dramatic, all right? And be emotionally responsible. You might be feeling a certain way, but put it under check, put it under control. If not, it will discourage and demoralize a man. Last point, not knowing when to be his friend. Now, if you are engaging men, either as in a dating relationship or a proper marriage, you must understand that really one of a man's major needs also is a friend, all right? men are not as emotional. It doesn't mean men don't have emotions, but it means when it comes to relationship issues, men are not as emotional. Men are emotional, every human being has emotions, but generally women are way more emotional than men, and men don't express their emotions generally in relationships. They're not great at it. They express their emotions in the football field. So you see men shouting, grown men shouting, go! They're emotional, but the kind of things they put their emotions into, it's not the same thing with women, okay? So when it comes to relationships, men generally don't flow as emotionally as women. So one of the things they want from a relationship or marriage is friendship. They want a friend. This means that they want a woman that can also talk to them like he's their buddy, he's their guy. So it's not every time you must bring your emotional works or your emotional power or the full emotional you or the relationship you to the marriage. Sometimes talk to him like you are his guy, like you are a buddy. He wants to bounce things off you without the emotional pressure. All right? You need to understand that women get replenished when they have emotional companionship. Men get depleted when they have emotional companionship. So you notice that men, if they spend so much time with the opposite sex emotionally, they get depleted. They need time away. For women, it's opposite. When a woman is stressed, she needs time with the person she loves because she gets replenished by companionship, emotional companionship. Men get depleted by it. So once in a while, he wants to talk to you as a friend. He doesn't want the emotional. He doesn't want his babe. He just wants a guy. Somebody can bounce things off. Somebody can talk about things casually about. This is also shared in the Bible. In Titus chapter 2, I think verse 4, the Bible says, let the older women teach the younger women how to be friends with their husbands. Very important. So let the older women, because of their experience, you see Titus 2, I think from verse 3, 4, 5, you say, let the older women teach the younger women how to be friends with their husbands. This is what he said, is how to love their husbands. So that word love there, if you know about the Bible, you understand that the Bible in New Testament is written in Greek. So certain words like love, there are different kinds of love. So there is agape love, the God kind of love. There's sensual or sexual love. You know, that's eros, that's what gets erotic. Then there's filial kind of love. That's brotherly, paddy, friendship love. So that love in this Titus chapter 2 is paddy love, is friend, brotherly love. He said, let older women teach the younger women how to be like paddy or buddy or pal to their husbands. That's what they mean by love there. So basically, men like to talk to them. I tell my wife all the time that one of the reasons I love her so much is because, you know, she knows how to turn between just being the emotional wife to be my friend. So you know, she's my best friend. She's a person I can discuss almost anything with her because, you know, I know she won't take it off, she won't blow off the handle, she'll take it to an extreme. But you see, when you're just a totally emotional woman and you don't have other aspects, your friendship or body side developed, there are many things your husband or man cannot discuss with you because you will turn into an emotional discussion. He just wants to gist, he just wants to talk. You know, and so you must learn how to be able to put that aside. Maybe my wife will do a video on how she does it. And I know there are a lot of other women that have this aspect on lockdown. They are good at it. They're able to separate their emotional side and gist with the guy. Just gist, general gist, not emotional. You know, it can gist casual things and gist is without the emotional tension. All right, know when to be your guy's friend. Men love it. Men love to be able to have a buddy, somebody they can talk with. So that's why many men, you know, have wife or babe and also still try to keep in touch with their guys. If you have both, you know, you will have him to yourself more of the time because he can discuss business with you, discuss politics, discuss sports. You know, he doesn't have to always look for guys to discuss those things with because he can get the replenishing he needs from you also and not always the emotional part which depletes him. All right, I hope this was helpful. So these are 7 ways you can discourage or demoralize your man. All right, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and also send this to other ladies that would enjoy it. And make sure you turn on notifications so that you know when we have other videos out. If you need counseling, either with me or any of our Love It Now Marriage certified counselors, please do see details on the screen. Reach out to us and somebody will be willing to talk with you. God bless you. See you at the next video. Let's go.